Does a Shadow Throne box set hint at the fall of the Empire? Find out. You get a bunch of neophyte hybrids. You get the Patriarch, which is pretty cool. You get the Bomber Lady. You get the Primaris, and then the, I think I can't remember his name, the Psychic guy, which is kind of like that box that you got from Death Watch. And that's on the GSC side. And then on the Adeptus Custodes, you get three of Alaris Terminators. You get the Blade Champion, or Champion of Blades, whatever you call it, and five Sisters of Silence. So, you know, overall, not the largest amount of stuff in the box, but you do get a bunch of HQs on one side on the GSC side, and you kind of get a bunch of HQs on the other side, on the Custode side, because all the stuff in here can be made into HQs, which is pretty interesting, because you can kind of fill out and get all those characters all in one single slew. So there's really two new units in the book. You have the Blade Champion, which is a super Kung Fu Blade Master, along the lines of some of the Grey Knights kind of Blade Champions, or the Emperor's Champion. He comes in, he hits really hard. He's hard to hit because he can spin the blade around and block stuff. And he does do a little aura trick per these rules that allows other shield host friends to get a plus one to charge if he is already in engagement range. So he's kind of one of those guys that's going to go in first, kick the crap out of something, and go out. The other new unit is the Saboteur GSC character. It's kind of weird set of rules, because I expect their rules to change when the book comes out, because they're still kind of referencing the old rules, and according to the bits and pieces we've gotten from Games Workshop, it doesn't seem to match up. But she places a bomb, and if people come near it, it can explode and do stuff. So you could put her near an objective, she'll throw a bomb as an action, and whenever you decide, you can explode something, and all of a sudden people can do more wounds around it. So it's a weird idea. I think we'll see if there's more to it, if she can maybe sabotage or pre-sabotage stuff in the book, or maybe there's some stratagems that sync up with what she can do. According to all the MSRP for the characters and all the pieces, then yes, this box is worth it, because you do get a lot of stuff out there. I do like how, with Custodes in general, every box set can easily create a character, create another piece, so you get a lot of units from a very small, you know, set of options. Sisters of Silence are always the weird addition, but per the leaked information, it looks like they might be troops or might be very important in the game. So everything in that box is probably going to be usable on the Custode side. And then on the GSC side, every single piece is usable. The only one that we have a question on is what the Saboteur is going to do later on in any kind of game on there. So overall, I think if you have these armies or want to play these armies and you want this, this is not a bad box set to buy. It gives you both. Maybe you can trade with a friend and split it 50-50. And someone gets some gold boys, or someone gets some creepy guys that live in the shadows. From what we get bits of information in this, the GSC side, again, it references a lot of old rules. It doesn't talk about any of the overlapping fire or any other stuff that got leaked out. But the Custode side's a lot more interesting. It appears that all the character Custodes all look to have gained an extra wound and an extra attack. So that's kind of interesting too, because I'm wondering if that's going to kind of cascade throughout the whole book. So you see shield captains on bikes getting 8 wounds. You have all the single characters holding the banners getting 8. The other bit of information is all the Vexillas, which is all the icons they carry. One gives dense cover, one gives light cover. So to core options. So that's pretty interesting too. So you can basically could maybe have two guys running around that you basically overlap, and you're now and always in dense and light cover. So for a bunch of 2-up save guys, that means they're going to probably be very hard to shift. Which could happen. I mean, and then we don't know about the Marshall Kata that's going to come out too, and those whole levels and layers of those things. So while this doesn't give us a ton of information, it does give us enough little kind of tidbits to maybe say, hey, you know, are Custodes getting tougher with more options, and maybe are GSC getting cheaper or anything else on there, or, you know, maybe there's some kind of other options going on there. But we'll have to wait and see. Hopefully we'll see in a week, couple weeks or two. So, I mean, the bigger thing I feel that's interesting on this is that they're having the Gene Sealer cults attack Terra. And that's a kind of weird setup, because usually we leave Terra for what you call like big storyline pushes, right? Remember back in the old edition where Gilliman was coming back and he had to go see his father after he fought Mortarion on the moon. And he had to go see his father, everything else, carrying Cypher along with him. And we were hoping maybe he's going to stab the sword in the Emperor, and the Emperor's going to get reborn as some kind of good chaos god or something else like that. Nothing like that happened, but, you know, this is always like the Terra is always kind of like a center point for something. And so to say the GSC are coming to Terra, you know, what kind of stuff brings you to your mind? I mean, here's this crazy cult on the golden, you know, the main homeworld of 40 of the Space Marines. And are they influencing there and start digging in there? And you think, how are they going to dig in there? Because if they have a bunch of this crazy psychic stuff, and though they have a whole lot of things, how are they going to get in there? And somehow they do. And also, does that mean that some Tyranids are going to come too? Because usually when you have the cult in there, they're eventually going to start building something or calling out to space and be like, hey, space daddies, come down here and eat us. I mean, no, come down here. We want to worship you. Take us to space. And they're all going to be wearing some Nike sneakers and shave their heads and live in bunk beds or something like that. But it's kind of, I mean, it's neat. I mean, you don't see this kind of fluff push. And I remember in, I think, the last GSC book that there was this whole weird section of these Space McDonald's Corporation who would take these space cows or bovines or everything else with these giant meat, and the cult had infiltrated that factory, and they started putting patriarchs or gene stealers inside the bovines, sewing them up and shipping them across space, increasing the cult around. So I would love it if somehow the fluff continued into that, because I thought that was a pretty interesting thing. Do you know the four-armed Ronald McDonald of Space Doom, which sounds, you know, kind of goofy and kind of weird, but, you know, very 40k. So overall, it's kind of neat. Like, we've asked for fluff to move forward, we asked for things to move forward, and, you know, a lot of the pieces of the campaign kind of is the whole, we're gonna do something, there's this huge giant fight, and then everything's still the same. So is this gonna stay the same? Is this gonna be importance to the whole new stuff coming? Who knows? I kind of like the idea that we're gonna see something crazy Nids coming too. Maybe they ate a bunch of Custodes and became golden space insect monster gods of doom. Who knows? But overall, pretty neat, pretty cool. So maybe worth checking out just to read. If you like this content, check out this video here. I'm Goat Boy from Bella Lost Souls. I'll see you next time.